In this video, we take a look at the top 5 features coming your way in SAP Analytics Cloud. These include Smart Insights optimize story experience and DataSphere support, Analytical Insights with Joule, Data Analyzer pin insights to a story visualization, Live Data connectivity to Google BigQuery, and Multi-Actions PAPM step. Hi, my name is Orla Cullen, and these are your What's New updates for QRC2 2025. Smart Insights has been a popular feature in SAP Analytics Cloud since the very beginning. It aims at explaining a data point or a variant with top contributors. And we are delighted to announce that in this release, the availability of Smart Insights in Optimized Story Experience, and also be supported by SAP Analytics Cloud Models, SAP DataSphere Models, and Live SAP HANA Models. Here we are in an optimized story that displays sales KPIs. We see that the sales promotions are 4.35% above plan. Let's see what Smart Insights can tell us about that. With a simple right click, we can launch Smart Insights. We understand that despite decreasing by over 2 million in Q2, we are still above plan. Let's see how Smart Insights can explain the sales promotion variation to plan. The subscription product has a huge impact that is partly compensated by the pay-as-you-go products, the business technology platform products, and the contract level also explains this variance. Smart Insights can also explain this data point in charts. For instance, here we want to explain the growth in operational expenses in May compared to April. The growth is driven by the business applications, products, a pay-as-you-go part type, and also long sales cycles of 18 months to 2 years. Let's see how we can get Smart Insights from an SAP DataSphere data model. We create a new optimized story, and we create a new chart using an SAP DataSphere analytical model. We've created numeric points to display the sales promotion, and exactly as we did earlier, we right-click on the figure to get Smart Insights. We see that La Quinta Hotels and Towers has the top sales promotion per customer. We also see that the top 10 customers got 1.6 million, or 8% of the total, so it looks like the promotions are spread across many customers. On the other hand, one-year payment terms and C-level contracts get the bulk of sales promotions. As we are in edit mode, we can add the chart to the story. We can then run Smart Insights again to find the top contributors and explain the sales promotions for analytics products. Again, we see customer payment terms and contract levels explain what is driving our sales promotions, but it's also explained by different dimensions such as customer status and sector.
Joule, SAP's AI chatbot, revolutionizes how users interact with SAP applications such as SAP SuccessFactors, SAP Start, and SAP S/4HANA. Joule now provides natural language query capabilities, and for this, it leverages SAP Analytics Cloud Just Ask.
SAP application users can now ask questions such as, what is the amount of sales commission this month? Just Ask uses natural language query conversational features to understand the user's questions. For example, when different data models could provide the relevant answers. Users can also refine their questions, for instance, to compare with last month. Joule also retains the history of the conversation so that users can follow their thought process while leveraging the reasoning provided by Just Ask. For instance, to convert local currencies to euros, to ask for a breakdown for the top 10 sales agents, and iterate from the previous question to limit the focus on Italy. Joule can start a new conversation at any time, for instance, to check the average units sold by sales order or to get sales agent with over 1,000 units sold last year. Joule explains the generated query that includes, in this case, a value-based filter.
An exciting new enhancement in this quarter is the new save and pin feature in the Data Analyzer. As a story viewer, you have the option to save and then at the same time pin the insight to the widget you have opened in Data Analyzer.
I open my story in story view mode. The story designer has enabled Data Analyzer, so I can open it directly to my data exploration. I'm interested in more details about Canada, so I can slice and dice this analysis. I also want to see more KPIs, and when I'm done with my exploration view, I want to save and pin it to my story. In the Save dialog, you'll find the Save and Pin to Story right beside the Save button. I give it a name, and I save and pin.
I can do the same for Germany by changing the filter, and again, I can save and pin it to the same story widget. I exit Data Analyzer and I'm back in my story, and in the context menu, I'll find my pinned insights. By clicking on the name, you open it in overlay mode, and with the icon here, you can open it in a new tab. You can also delete the insights directly from the context menu. The same functionality is available if you open Data Analyzer using the Script API. You'll also find the Save and Pin button here, and the insight is again pinned to the widget.
This quarter, we bring you the ability to connect to Google BigQuery data sources with a new live data connection. And there will be many other live SQL sources to follow.
You can now benefit from the Google BigQuery live data integration into SAP Analytics Cloud. This significant improvement will allow you to leverage your actual data directly from Google BigQuery data lakes, while incorporating it seamlessly into SAP Analytics Cloud as if the data were locally replicated. This important milestone unlocks federation capabilities in SAP Analytics Cloud models. You will now be able to leverage Google BigQuery data within SAP Analytics Cloud models as if they were local, enabling enhanced analytics and decision-making.
Last, but by no means least, in this release, we introduce a dedicated step type in the multi-action to call a PAPM process. This will make calling PAPM processes much more straightforward for SAP Analytics Cloud users. So let's take a look at this in action.
I start by right-clicking, and you'll see I now have a new PAPM integration step. When I add that, I'm prompted to give it a step name. I have to select a specific PAPM connection, and I then have the ability to select from an existing process or create a new execution. Here I'm going to create a new execution. I'm going to get the activity I want by selecting the environment, the process template, and then the activity. And when I select those parameters, I then get a list of specific parameters available for that activity. I can then define either by selecting a member or selecting a variable that I want to pass through to that execution. In this case, the variables are amount, customer, and date, and I can then save my multi-action. Back in my story, we see our trigger for the multi-action. And when I execute the multi-action, I'm now prompted for the dynamic parameter for the date, and it makes the call to PAPM. Back in PAPM, we can see the process we initiated.
Thank you for joining us to learn all about some of the top features coming your way in the Q2 2025 release cycle of SAP Analytics Cloud. Check out the video description for more links to resources about this quarter's updates. And also remember to leave a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all things SAP Analytics Cloud. Thanks again, I'll see you next time.